few hours ago, the Chancellor, Rishi Sunak, delivered this year's budget. Interestingly, within his budget speech, he did say, now is not the time to set detailed fiscal changes. And with that in mind, what did we see in relation to income tax and capital gains tax? Well, effectively, the rates of income tax have not been changed at all. So the main rates of income tax remain at 20%, 40% and 45% for most sources of income. For example, employment income, pension income, rental property income, etc. And they remain at 7.5%, 32.5% and 38.1% for dividend income in relation to whether you're a basic rate taxpayer or high rate taxpayer. In addition, we've seen no change to the starting rate band for savings income, which remains at £5,000, the personal savings allowance, which remains at £1,000 for basic rate taxpayers and £500 for higher rate taxpayers, and also in relation to the dividend allowance, which remains at £2,000. However, what we did see is that there will be a slight increase to the personal allowance for income tax from the 6th of April, where it will be set at £12,570, and it will be frozen at this level until the 5th of April 2026. In relation to capital gains tax then, the main rates will remain at 10% and 20% for most capital gains, and at 18% and 28% where an individual makes a capital gain on the sale of residential property, for example, a buy-to-let, so a property that is not their main residence. The annual exemption for capital gains tax will remain at £12,300, and it will remain at this level, again frozen, until the 5th of April 2026. With this in mind, when the personal allowance is frozen and the capital gains tax annual exemption is frozen, a lot of clients, you know, this will not be welcomed news, primarily because they'll find themselves paying higher rates of income tax on more of their income, as well as their capital gains. All's not lost though, because we've got a lot of information on Techlink, which will enable you to help cater for planning ideas for your clients. Primarily, something to think about is ensuring that their assets and investments are arranged in such a way to maximise use of these allowances and exemptions. And remember, of course, that we have got the tax health check. So on completion of the questionnaire, this enables you to see the planning opportunities available for them to use their allowances and exemptions. And the meeting planner provides you with opportunities that you can discuss with your clients in relation to maximising these allowances and exemptions.